cascaded three steps and reactors. In reality, chemical reactions are not spontaneous and not complete because there's a need for them to pass through one phase of reaction to the other. That's why we are looking at it at cascaded level. The extent of reaction is being affected by various factors, which are nature of reactants, the reaction temperature, the mixing rates, among other factors. Now, looking at this system is already in operation. We have sodium hydroxide. We have two reactants here, like we have 2.3 weight per weight percent sodium hydroxide, and we have 5% ethylacetate. They are being pumped to the test tank reactor, and then it's engaged to work at equal volume. So when it reaches this particular gauge, it spills over to the second test tank reactor, and after that, it spills over to the third one. It may interest us to know that we want to set this at the same stirring rate. Okay, we set the pump at 80 and the other one too at 80. Then the stirring of the first reactor at maximum and the second one at maximum. Now we have liquid flowing into the third one, so we can turn the stirrer for that also and set it at maximum. The aim of the experiment is to evaluate the effect of stirring time with conversion and also to test the performance of the cascaded third tank reactor. We see how to measure the extent of reactant in each tank. Alright, so we are going to measure for tank 1, tank 2, tank 3, and the fourth one to the dead time tank here. So to do that, let's have our indicators here. This is for reactor 1, and then we can measure the conductivity. It's important to note that the conversion is related to conductivity by the formula . Now let's see how to take the readings for reactor 1, reactor 2, and reactor 3. Like I said, the essence of reaction is being related to conductivity. So for reactor 1, we have 0.4 ms per cm at 30.9 degrees centigrade. Alright? And then you can switch to reactor 2. And then take your readings after 5 seconds for it to be stabilized. There you see that we have 1.4 ms per cm at 30.7 degrees. And then we move to reactor 3. We wait for 5 seconds as well. And then you see we have 4.1 ms per cm at 30.7 degrees centigrade. So that's clearly how to measure the conductivity, and then you can now translate it to conversion. We are meant to do this particular experiment for various parameters as stipulated manner. And then after that, you correlate your readings with graphical explanation just to show us which reactor offers the highest conversion, and then also tell us about the overall conversion of the system. Thank you very much.